best one, friends. We have here Coach Sherwin Meneses and Erica Stanton of the 3-point Coast Smashers who won in straight sets against the Chalco Mujong Flying Titans. Coach, congratulations on this straight set win. Nung third set, medyo shaky yung naging game ng team line, pero nakabawi naman. Anong masasabi mo sa performance ng team?
Syempre masaya kami at naka-recover kami dun sa third set after ng two sets win namin. Siguro papataas ng moral. Challenge yung team namin dun sa third set. Medyo malayo yung hinabol. So happy kami that naka-recover kami.
Thank you, coach. For Erica, you had 19 points in this game. I guess what was going through your head in that third set where you guys had to recover from a deficit?
Yeah, honestly, just leaning on my teammates, just knowing that if we were going to do it, we were going to do it together. And I just really appreciated all the confidence that they had in me to, and Atakaile had in me to feed me the ball. I was feeling good in that third set. It took a minute. I think I started off slow in the first set, so my teammates really had my back throughout that game and just waited for me to start getting a hot hand and being able to put the ball away. So honestly, all credit to my teammates.
Coach, ano yung masabi yung sa naging composure ng team niyo ng third set? Ang layo nung hinabo, lalo na si Pangs na steady siya dun sa service line.
Siguro blessing sa amin yung ano, yung nangyari, yung experience namin yung opportunity na yung composure namin is tumaas, maging maganda. Kasi syempre yung quarterfinals lumalapit na. So magandang test sa amin yung nangyari kanina. So, yeah, katulad yung sabi ni Erica, yung teamwork nandun na. Yung experience nandiyan naman. Siguro yung reality na paglalaro nung first six namin yung hinahanap namin.
Erica, this is your first time to play against Team Line Sister Team Chalco Mucho. What can you say about the environment? And I guess, how did you stay calm throughout, you know, the jam-packed arena?
Yeah, honestly, that was like some of the most, like, I mean, hands down, the most fun volleyball environment I've ever been a part of. So I knew coming into it that there were going to be a lot of fans, there were going to be a lot of eyes watching, but kind of just wanted to focus on enjoying it because, you know, you never know if I'm ever going to play in a crowd like that again. So just really enjoying the moment. And then I had a coach when I was like my last year of college at Georgia who's kind of had this one saying, I hope I get it right, but it's play for the two, not for the 30,000. So basically, you're playing the same game, whether it's like your two best friends just watching you in the gym and you're playing like loose, playing to have fun. You're playing the same game as if you'd be playing in front of 30,000 people. So kind of just checking back into that and like we're playing the game that we love no matter how many people are watching. So that kind of helped settle the nerves a little bit, and then just really embracing like the number of fans that are here that love Chalco Mucho and Creamline. It's just honestly incredible the amount of people that love volleyball in the Philippines. So it's great.
For Erica, of course, there were thousands of fans there that are Creamline fans. And so for you, with all those eyes watching and the inherent pressure of being Creamline's import, no less than for any team, how are you handling that pressure of playing for a champion team, one of the bigger teams here? And in your personal assessment, are you hoping well with such a crowd, such expectations of you as well?
Yeah, honestly, I think like going back, like, 2 months ago when I first got here, I think it was a little bit daunting just hearing about, you know, how many fans Creamline has and just like their history of success. So I think there was a little bit of pressure. Also, this being my first like pro league, so coming out of college. So definitely 2 months ago, I think it was a little bit daunting, but I think I came into the best program that I possibly could for that sort of environment, because one of the first things they said to me was just, they have no added pressure. They Creamline just plays. They want to keep it fun. They want to keep it light. And so there's a reason why so many people love Creamline, so many fans love Creamline, and why they're so successful. So I came into a program that just really made sure to emphasize that they're putting no extra pressure on me and to just go out there, have fun, enjoy the moment, enjoy being with my teammates. So that's what I've focused on the past couple months.
Coach, alam naman natin na hindi talaga basis kung sumubo yung team. Kinu-shock account lang yung character na pinakita ng Creamline na ang laki nung hinabol nyo, and then to win it in such a exciting fashion pa sa dito.
Yung character naman ng mga players na test na namin, individual kasi mga seniors na rin yung mga nasa loob, pero yung as a team, yun yung hinahanap talaga namin, yung character ng as a team. So lumabas naman ngayon, sana magpatuloy pa hanggang sa quarterfinals din para maging maganda yung mga laro namin. Naging test sa amin.
You guys were down in third set as many as 9 points, but you guys made that run. I guess in that run of yours, was there a moment where you felt like, oh, we're going to make this comeback happen?
Honestly, I think the whole time we kind of believed that we could make the comeback happen no matter how big the deficit got. We kind of just had faith in each other and just in our team that if we kind of kept our heads up and like just kept working point by point, I think we knew that we could come out of it. And I think we knew that like energy and momentum was going to be a huge part of that comeback. And, you know, we made sure that we kind of kept that and worked towards that. So that was probably the biggest thing, was just playing united and playing point by point.
Coach, in-announce po recently na hindi na po makakabalik si yung mga last players na si Jeremy yung makakabalik. So, paano lang po mag-adjust yung team or kapag-adjust na po ba moving forward?
Siyempre, malaking kawalan talaga yung mga alas players, pero since nag-start yung conference talagang nag-training at nag-expect kami na kung hindi sila makabalik, ito yung magiging team namin. So, we try na mag-improve lang kami every game. Kesa nandiyan yung alas or wala, yun lang yung sa amin.
Sir, Coach, your last game in the preliminaries
will
be against Zuzkov. So, ano yung magiging mindset
na yung pinag-alim to that game? Siyempre, kailangan maging ma-improve kami papasok ng quarterfinals. Kasi pinaka-importante is yung quarterfinals. So, bibigay kami ng 110% sa last game namin. So, madala namin sa quarterfinals. So, training muna ulit kami.
Thank you, Coach. Thank you, Erica.